Okay, bitch. Listen, I was really just gonna give the review for well, thoughts and comments, rather, bitch, for basketball wise. It's supposed to be LA, but bitch, I guess it ain't. But for shits and giggles, and six of me having, you know, some more subscribers. Hey, subscribers, how y'all doing, Hinty? I'ma go on ahead and do this dry ass shit for Love and Fairy Tales, Atlanta. I'm calling it Love and Fairy Tales because there's only one nigga up there doing any type of hip hop at all, and that's Waka Flocka Ugly Ass. But for the sake of, you know, doing this whole YouTube shit, I'ma go on ahead and give it to y'all. So this was season 6, episode 7, Grapes of Wrath. Listen, I missed a couple of episodes. I don't care. Listen, I'm on my funky Dineva shit, bitch. I'm calling out all the fake and phony. Cause it needs to be. You know, when the season first came out, and even with season 2, there was a lot of real shit that was going on, and you could tell it was real about the way that people would react, by the way that the cast members to respond to certain shit, and you could feel the realness in it. I could say that for the first and the second season. After the first and the second season, bitch, may as well say after K. Michelle left, everything just started being so fake, so phony. I don't give a fuck who in VH1 see this shit, bitch. Good. You need to see it so you can hear what the fuck the masses is really saying, honey, because I'm over it. It's kind of like the Real Housewives franchise. I'm over it. I doubt I'm going to be around to stick around to see a season 7, bitch, unless y'all get a brand new cast of females and guys. If not, wrap this shit up and bring in something else. Bring in Love & Hip Hop Houston, Love & Hip Hop Miami, hell, Love & Hip Hop Virginia, bitch. I would love to see what the fuck Missy got going on, and Timbaland got going on, and Genuine got going on, and Eclipse got going zone, and Pharrell got going zone. Like, it's so many other cities y'all could go to and get some real shit with. Why continue to stick around Atlanta? For the fuck what? Child, I'm tired of seeing the Georgia goddamn peaches, because the Georgia goddamn peaches ain't doing a motherfucking thing for my spirit or my soul. However, for this video, I'm going to go on ahead and see what I get for you. Fake ass scene. Mariah and Sierra. Sierra, let me listen. Sierra, and listen, bitch. I'm not all the way here for you, but don't know women deserve to be cheated on. And I totally get and understand where the fuck you coming from. I understand your gripe. However, bitch, you and I both know. Shooter ass ain't cute. Shooter ass not fine. He actually looks like a meerkat to me. And him having dreads make it even worse. I mean, and bitch, personally, how can you ever feel comfortable? I don't give a fuck how many hundreds and thousands of dollars that you getting for these little episodes you're getting. It probably ain't much, bitch. Maybe 5, 6, 7 thousand, maybe 10. You know what I'm saying? But bitch, fuck. You could blow through 10 in 2 weeks. You know, and then you have a shop, you make your little money. I mean, it's dry, it's an old lady shop, but bitch, somebody like it. Hell, you say you was wearing a $15,000 this and a $7,000 that. You know, I see you making your coins. What is Shooter doing for him to ever feel like it's acceptable to cheat on you? I mean, I've never heard of him. I know he ain't no rapper, bitch. I've never heard of no motherfucking Shooter. Never seen him before in the day of my goddamn life. Is he a ghostwriter? Does he produce? Does he make beats? You know, is he the assistant of the assistant? Do he get coffee and donuts for the crew? What is your claim to fame, Shooter, that you ever feel like it's okay for you to cheat on a bitch that's really taking care of you? Like in the last previous season when you gave Mariah that fake ass money. Bitch, we all can see that shit y'all got from the motherfucking dollar store, Toys R Us. Y'all know the shit that you got to pull off from the from the shit like the pop-ups and shit like that. Y'all know the fake ass money. Yeah, it won't no creases in it, no dents, no watermark. I mean, it was fake as shit. Yeah, I can understand you only giving her maybe $1,000 here and there, but bitch, $1,000 to who money? It can't be yours. It gotta be your wife's. So not only are you cheating on your wife, you giving this bitch money. But whatever, Sierra must like it to an extent. That's why I said the shit was fake. Because any real wife who was really caught off guard, any real wife who just found out her husband has been cheating on a bitch that she considered her little sister, gave this bitch a job, treated this bitch like family, and you find out that not only has she been fucking your husband, but she been basically taking money for the shit. I mean, you try to go upside her head one time, but bitch, that one time, and then you do what you always do. I'm over it and walk the fuck off. That's Mona is fake. It's fake. It's fake. It's fake. Mona, Carlos, all of y'all bitches, listen to me. It's fake, and we know it is. Hell, y'all could at least gave that bitch a damn legitimate Bernadine moment to at least make us feel like, oh, okay, well, she not some weak, stuck up, uppity ass bitch that really don't know how to defend herself and her marriage and her family. But whatever, that's just how the fuck I feel. I'm quite sure maybe some of y'all don't feel the same way I do, but bitch, fuck it, that's how the fuck I feel. That's what the fuck I said. I said what the fuck I had to say. I'm not taking it back. It was a fake ass scene. Shooter, you ugly as shit. Mariah, you about big as my motherfucking pinky. But you know what, Mariah, I'm gonna tell you this though, I don't think you lying. I believe every word you said. You took him home. He bored because his wife works every day. He don't do shit but sit at home with his hands in his pants, eating bonbons, watching ESPN all day. Like my man do, but bitch, at least my man got a job and he come home and do that. So I don't say shit to him about it. You know, he was bored. He look at you a typical young dumb bitch who moved away from your friends and family, came out here to Atlanta with not a dime to your name. So you figure, bitch, I'm in Atlanta, may as well get my diamond on, do what the fuck I got to do so I get to where the fuck I need to go. He see that in you. You're easily influenced. You're down for the cause anyway. You know, my wife's always at work. I ain't got shit to do. Bitch, give me something to do. And you know, I know you ain't got shit. So I go on ahead and give you a little fun here and there. Basically paying you for your services. You know, you trying to extort $70,000 from this man. I don't know where the fuck you got it from. I highly doubt you got it from Shooter. He ain't got no money, bitch. Whatever type of $70,000 that you trying to make us feel like you got from him, if you did, you didn't get it from him. He got it from his wife to give to you. But that's all the fuck I got to say about that. And then leading up to this shit with that fake ass table scene, you know, I'm just gonna give you an opportunity to say what you gotta say. Mariah trying to tell you her plight. You not buying it. She tells you to your face she sees you as a joke. Mariah, quiet as this cat, bitch, we all see you as a joke too. You just a young and dumb, inexperienced little bitch running around here, floating around Atlanta, trying to figure it out because you left the confines of your own home to come down to Atlanta, like most young people do, and there's nothing wrong with that. But when you start breaking up families is where there is something wrong with that. And karma is a bitch, and they call karma a bitch for a motherfucking reason. And guess what? Karma, my bitch. I fucks with karma, okay? Because karma will get you way better than anybody else would. So, Mariah, if you woman enough to break up somebody's happy home, I hope you woman enough to be prepared to take your karma and receive it for when it comes. What else? Shit. These little scenes with Jocelyn and her brother. I didn't know the bitch even had a brother. I didn't even know she knew her fucking family. I guess we finally realizing that some of that tea ain't true either. She may not know her family, but she damn sure don't know who the fuck her brothers and shit is. And he was kind of cute, seemed kind of cool, but Jocelyn, I'm baby, you trying to do this whole Dr. Phil, y'all fix my life type of shit, and I'm just not here for it. You know, when you came on first season, you was the biggest bitch that I've ever seen grace my fucking TV. And although I did not like you and what you brought out of me with that, I did like the drama and the realness, and you know how you just didn't give a fuck, bitch, I'm doing me. If you don't like it, you can kiss my ass. My point to you, Jocelyn, if you're gonna be a bitch from season one, don't wait to get to season six, you pregnant, then you don't want to be no bitch no more. No, God, reality TV don't work like that. And I kind of felt like that's why they bought in Lovely Mimi. I personally feel like Lovely Mimi is finna take your spot, because now you a mother, you getting dry and boring, you really don't have nothing else going for yourself other than being this man baby mama. I mean, the song may be cute, but Jocelyn, let's just be real, bitch. I live in Virginia. I've never heard not name none of your song in a bar, in a club, in a gay club. No, nothing. And then there's no shade to you, ma. Maybe this is your calling for music, and you just ain't met the right producer to bring that up out of you yet. But I mean, I'm just overseeing you. I'm over these forced ass scenes between you and Stevie. You and Stevie don't want each other no more, bitch. Quite frankly, I'm glad. Y'all don't need to be with each other, because y'all don't do shit to bring each other down. What else? You know, like with the whole scene about baby Bella maybe not being Stevie's bitch. We all knew that it was Stevie. We all knew this bitch wanted a Stevie J baby so goddamn bad. She was going to die until she got one. Now she got one. So we could go on ahead and fire their asses. Get them the fuck off of Love & Hip Hop Atlanta and bring in two new bitches. Jock. What went on with Jock? Not really much went on with Jock. Mimi, we really didn't see Mimi until the end. We didn't see Rashida until the end. I'm over this Rashida and Kirk shit too. Bitch, you still fucking them. Bitch, you still with them. You all down on Snapchat and you know Facebook and Instagram and your husband this and your family that and blah, blah, blah. Bitch, the least you can do is wait until the reunion come out and then do all of this shit if you really want us to believe your storyline. But you know, whatever. You gotta go through that shit, bitch, not me. Because my price is way too high to sit here and be okay with my husband fucking another bitch, or at least proclaiming to be fucking another bitch. Not only fucking another bitch, but you got the bitch pregnant. Not only did you get the bitch pregnant, you was fucking the bitch and her friend. But whatever. What else? Child, I'm trying to squeeze water out of a watermelon, child, and I'm down to the last rhyme. Tommy and Dime. Tommy, listen. While I can understand where you coming from, bitch, I'm a grown ass woman. You understand me? I don't owe nobody any explanation about who I like, who I love, and who I decide to be friends with, and who I decide to forgive and forget. Which is what I don't understand about any of you hoes. That shit you do back in high school. But let me tell you something. Even when I was in Phoebus, couldn't nobody tell me who the fuck I can and can't be friends with. Bitch, if you not friends with her, that shit has nothing to do with me. But I am cool with you and I am cool with her. Now, I will not bring the two of y'all around each other. I will not, you know, put y'all in a predicament to where, you know, there's going to be an issue. There's going to be a gripe. There may be a fight. You know what I'm saying? I would never do that. I would never, you know, well, listen, whatever your beef is with her, don't talk about her around me, because you know that's my bitch. Whatever you say about her to anybody else, I have nothing to do with that. I'm not there to witness it. But when you with me, that's my friend. That's something that you need to respect, and vice versa. For y'all old ass bitches to sit around, well, if you friends with this bitch, then me and you can't be friends. That is the lamest shit for an adult to do. Tammy and Dime get into it. I really not understanding what the big deal was. Listen, I'm not all the way here for Tammy either. However, I do feel where Tammy is coming from. Did it really require all of that? You know, we don't want to keep talking about Jocelyn and this and that and the third. So she segued into her nails. Dime, did you really have to do all of that? But at the same time, Tammy, bitch, I'm so sick of you acting like you big and bad. Bitch, let me tell you one thing I learned from my daddy. A nigga or a bitch that can whoop ass will get up and whoop ass. The first thing on their mind isn't, let me grab a wine glass. Let me grab a wine bottle. That seems to be your thing. You know, I'm going to pick up a drink and throw it at you first. Or, you know, I'm going to pick up a glass, bitch, and I'm going to try to, you know what I'm saying, knock you out. And then I'm going to come for your jugular. Tammy, get out of here with that shit. At the same time, you got to take some responsibility for that too. Whatever the fuck she said to you, she said to stand down in her seat, bitch. You the one that had to get up, grab a wine glass, trying to throw it at her. Nova Gras for Mimi, bitch. Y'all got Po Mimi sitting down in the middle of this shit. She looking around. She both y'all friends, so she don't really want to say nothing to make it seem like, you know, you more on this side, you more on that side. It looks like a really forced scene that everybody just decided to come to. And I mean, Tommy, you my bitch. We go way back. This whole wine thing is not a good idea, boo. It is not a good idea. I mean, you bringing sand to the beach. I mean, Tommy, there's so many other things you can do. You are such a beautiful woman. You can model. You know what I'm saying? You could try to be a Ford model, a Playboy model, something, bitch. Go to school, get a trade, be a nail tech. You know what I'm saying? Chill around, let me meet me. She'll show you how to do the nails and shit, bitch. Y'all could team up and, you know, open a shop together. I mean, do you know how to do hair? You know what I'm saying? You know how to shampoo? You know how to box weave and all the shit that y'all bitches be getting? You know what I'm saying? Y'all could team up and do something like that. I mean, Tommy, there are so many other things, bitch, that you can do and you could waste your money on than a wine that will get people fucked up in one shit, bitch. I don't want no wine that's 15, 16, 17, 18% proof, bitch. Because I'm a wine drinker. You fucking people up with your wine, honey. And I really don't see that shit selling all around the world like you think it is. I mean, it may sell yang around Atlanta. But, you know, in the little low-budget one-stop corner stores and shit. But, you know, I don't see it at True Wine and in the ABC stores and, you know, the high-end liquor stores. I don't see it there. KK was absolutely right. You need professional help, bitch, before you try to sit here and indulge in an endeavor such as making wine when you're clearly an alcoholic. Tommy admitted, bitch, you an alcoholic. Listen, we all are addicted to something. It takes a big person to admit that they're addicted to it. You sitting here saying that you're not, when, bitch, we all clearly know that you are, it's futile. Get your life together. You know, the way you did Jessica, you was really fucked up, and I really felt like you owe her an apology. And Dime, you know what I'm saying? You coming off on Tammy the way you did was really fucked up, and I really feel like you owe her an apology. And Tammy, I really feel like you owe Jessica and Tommy an apology. You owe Jessica an apology because, bitch, y'all was sitting down having an argument. You did not have to get up out your seat, try to throw a glass at her. That was way too much. That was already a heated situation, and it was going to turn up even a whole lot more because, Tammy, while I don't have a problem with you, I do not feel like you can handle Jessica Dime. And Jessica Dime, you also owe Tammy an apology for even doing all of that shit in the beginning. You just could have shut the fuck up and finished saying what the fuck you had to say, bitch. Honestly. And don't get me wrong, Dime, I fuck with you. Out of everybody, I fuck with you. I don't want no beef. I don't want no issue. Bitch, I'm all here for J Dime, honey, and I want to see you win. You're doing a really good thing by trying to be cool and cordial with everybody. See, Dime, I see what you're trying to do, but for shit like this, it just don't work that way. Unfortunately, you're going to have to dislike somebody. You're going to have to dislike somebody's in order to really have a full, substantial, you know, role. And, you know, or what role you do play in Love and Hip Hop. I mean, I get where you're coming from, bitch, and I feel you, child. I got real drama going on. I ain't got time to be dealing with fake, contrived drama. But, you know, whatever. Tommy Mama done showed up. We're gonna see what happens with that shit. But, y'all, that was pretty much it. Love and Hip Hop really didn't give much of nothing. It never really has this season. There's just a lot of fake and phony fairy tales and lies that are going on. But if that's what makes for good reality TV, bye, Mona. then that's fine. I can say whatever the fuck I want to say, Mona. Listen, I'm not trying to get no checks off of this shit. I just like to interact with people up here and give the real tea of how I really feel about some of this shit. So whoever from Love & Hip Hop see this shit, y'all feel some type of way, bitch, hit me up. Let me know your thoughts and concerns, and I'm going to tell you why I feel the way I feel and why the masses feel the same way that I feel and why y'all need to go on ahead and either A, fire all these bitches, get a whole new slew of young, actually being in the industry, men and women, follow them around, let's get to know them, or B, put this shit in the motherfucker archives and don't ever bring it out again. Those are just my only two things with Love & Hip Hop this season. Here I am really looking forward and hype to Love & Hip Hop Atlanta coming back out and y'all giving me this bullshit. I mean, hell, New York was way more entertaining than this shit. But, you know, whatever. It is what it is, y'all. That's all I got. I ain't got no more. I can't give y'all no more that from what ain't there. I'm surprised this video lasted 20 minutes, but, you know, it did. So, hey. But, all right, y'all. I'm about to get off of this shit. I'm off today, so I'm about to get off of this shit. Fix me some eat, and then I'm going to come back and call y'all, bitch, so we can get into the Basketball Wives that came on last night. All right, Gert. Bye.